Who needs a coffee when you can get right back at it? This morning, this was the scene at the St. Paul Curling Club barroom by around 9 a.m., and this was what it looked like from the ice at 3 a.m., both levels packed, glued to the TV. And of course, the appropriate reaction as the men's team won gold in Pyeongchang.
The place exploded, and then everybody had to get out. Managers need to go home.
Clay Orvik was one of the hundreds who stayed at the club to watch the match and was back on the ice early this morning.
I'm a little tired. I might take a nap after this game. We'll see.
The international men's tournament here at the St. Paul Curling Club just happened to fall on the same weekend as the gold medal game. So, late night, early morning for a lot of the players that had to be right back here.
Well, you're kind of on the edge of your seat, you know, hoping that they make all the shots and everything like that. And then in the eighth end, when they got five, it's like the place just went nuts.
With more than five Twin Cities curling clubs and roughly 20 around the state, it's a small community. Many of these players know the four members of Team USA and are looking forward to welcoming them back.
Knowing the people playing in the game, I found myself just enthralled, you know, because they're going to come home.
So no matter the hour, Team USA had its cheerleaders back home who are now eager to celebrate the golden finish. In St. Paul, Dylan Wollenhouse, Carol 11 News.
Roll out.